Our entrance hymn is Blessed Be the God of Israel, number 65 in our hymn books. 6-5.
Blessed be the God of Israel, who has redeemed us and has raised a mighty Savior promised by the prophets. He would free us from our foes and from all those who hate us. Thus his promise is fulfilled, his covenant remembered.
A very good morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning, Father.
And welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. We offer this Mass for all your intentions. We pray in a very special way for all those who celebrate their birthdays and wedding anniversaries today, all those who are sick and suffering, all those in need of God's mercy and compassion. We pause and pray. And let us begin this Eucharist in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, this Eucharist that we celebrate reminds us of what Jesus constantly tells us: ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and it will be opened to you. And so reminds us to be persistent in prayer. As we gather here, let us ask the Lord to help us grow in perseverance and determination, knowing and believing that the Lord will surely answer our every prayer. We pause and pray for this. Lord Jesus, you bring us your forgiveness. Together. Lord, O Lord, have mercy. Lord, O Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body. Together. Christ, O Christ, have mercy. Christ, O Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Together. Lord, O Lord, have mercy. Lord, O Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. O foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? It was before your eyes that Jesus Christ was publicly portrayed as crucified. Let me ask you only this. Did you receive the Spirit by works of the law or by hearing with faith? Are you so foolish? Having begun by the Spirit, are you now being perfected by the flesh? Did you suffer so many things in vain? If indeed it was in vain, does he who supplies the Spirit to you and works miracles among you do so by the works of the law or by hearing with faith? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited his people.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited his people.
He has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke by the mouth of his holy prophets from of old.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited his people.
That we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us, to show the mercy promised to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited his people.
Hallelujah, oh come praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Open our hearts, O Lord, that we may pay attention to the words of your Son.
Hallelujah, oh come praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Which of you who has a friend will go to him at midnight and say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine has arrived on a journey, and I have nothing to set before him.' And he will answer from within, 'Do not bother me, the door is shut, and my children are in bed with me. I cannot get up and give you anything.' I tell you, though he will not get up and give him anything, because he is his friend, yet because of his impudence, he will rise and give him whatever he needs. And I tell you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks it will be opened. What father among you, if his son asks for a fish, will instead of a fish give him a serpent? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The good news of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. May it become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. May it become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
We shall take the Eucharistic prayer in honor of Jesus, the way to the Father. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord, for by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Together we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people, grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your Kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing the Latin Our Father all together.
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other holy and a meaningful sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us make our spiritual communion with the Lord. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Our communion hymn is Ask and You Will Receive.
Ask and you will receive, seek and you will find, knock and the door will be opened, for the love of the Lord has no end. Is there anyone here when his son asks for bread, would turn him away with a stone instead? Is there anyone here when his son asks for meat, would then give him a poisonous snake to eat? Ask and you will receive, seek and you will find, knock and the door will be opened, for the love of the Lord has no end. So then how could your Father in heaven above, who knows so much more of the ways of love, so then how could your Father refuse what is good? When you ask him the name of the Son he loves, ask and you will receive, seek and you will find, knock and the door will be open, for the love of the Lord has no end.
We pray for our families, our loved ones, and all those in need of God's mercy and compassion altogether. Almighty God, keep our homes and all who dwell in it safe from all harm of the evil spirit. Preserve us in mind, body, and soul. Deliver our homes from fire, storm, and destruction of any kind. May our homes be a sanctuary of love, a place of growth in the likeness of Jesus, and a school of every Christian virtue. Holy Immaculate Mother of God and glorious Saint Joseph, protector and patron of our homes, save and protect us now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to Saint Jude. Most holy Apostle Saint Jude, faithful servant and friend of Jesus, the name of the traitor who delivered the beloved Master into the hands of his enemies, has caused you to be forgotten by many. But the Church honors and invokes you universally as the patron of hopeless cases, of things despaired of. Pray for me who am so miserable. Make use, I implore you, of that particular privilege accorded to you to bring visible and speedy help where help is almost despaired of. Come to my assistance in this great need, that I may receive the consolation and succor of heaven in all my necessities, tribulations, and sufferings, and that I may glorify God with you and all the elect throughout eternity. I promise you, O blessed Saint Jude, to be ever mindful of great favors, and will never cease to honor you as my special and powerful patron, and to do all in my power to encourage devotion to you. Amen. Prayer for the sick. Grant, Almighty and Eternal God, everlasting health to those who believe. Hear us for the sick, for whom we implore the aid of your tender mercy, that being restored to bodily health, they may give thanks to you in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Jesus, the Son of Mary, the Lord and Redeemer of the world, through the merits and intercession of his holy apostle Saint Jude, show us favor and mercy. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Saint Jude, pray for us. Amen.
Apostle of Jesus, a martyr, saint of all, the cousin of our Savior, of whom thy love at all. A writer of the scripture with tongues of fire aflame, the worker of great wonders in Jesus' holy name. Saint Jude, the oft forgotten, thou shalt remembered be. We hail thee now in glory, and have recourse to thee. Your help for the despairing, when hopeless seems the task, and from the heart of Jesus, through thee our favors